Hi guys and welcome, this is Kofi here. MTN recently officially launched their MTN TableNet device. I was invited to the event, I took some videos and pictures. You can see the highlights in my other video, you can check the link in the description below. In this video, I want to talk about some of the questions people normally ask me when it comes to this TableNet device. I've done a couple of videos you can also find in the link in the description about the TableNet and some of the speed tests and all that. So if you've not seen them, you can find them and watch them. In this particular video, some of the questions that I get asked, I'm going to try and answer them to the best of my understanding. And hopefully, if you know somebody who also has these questions and want answers too, you can share the video with them as well. So let's get right into it. What basically is TableNet?
MTN TableNet is a revolution in the fixed broadband space. It is a fixed wireless broadband router and provides speeds almost as fast as fiber. Now, what does MTN TableNet do for you? MTN TableNet gives you super high speed internet that can power gaming, streaming, downloading for work, for business, or for home use.
Now, your mileage is going to be different depending on where you are, your network reception, and a lot of factors. It's a fiber-like solution they've brought onto the market. But then, instead of bringing fiber to your home, you get that speed and reliability over the airways. So they don't have to bring in any fiber. You bundle just like a fixed broadband user and then you have that offering as well. Should you buy the TableNet? Well, it depends. If you currently have MTN fiber in your home, you don't need the TableNet. But if you are in an area where there is no fiber offering, it's not there yet, but you want to enjoy speeds up to or enjoy speeds like you're on fiber, then the MTN TableNet might be what you're looking for. If you're a heavy data user and you don't want bundling these small bundles, you know, you want something huge. Maybe you're a small business with 5 to 10 employees and you're looking for something like that to use. You want a fiber option but you don't get it, TableNet might be for you. If you're an individual, a freelance, a developer who uses data heavily and you're looking for something monthly based, this can be something you're also looking for. If you move around a lot but then still require reliable internet data for your workload, this also might be a solution for you, because unlike a fixed fiber in your home, this one you're getting that speeds but then when you're on the go. So we went on a trip with this TableNet, went through Tamale, went through Bolgatanga, went to Wah, and we still had good network reception and it was an amazing experience. So if you move around and you still want to carry your internet with you, this TableNet might be what you're looking for. How and where to get it? The simplest answer is just walk into any MTN office. So all their regional offices, they should have a copy of the device there for you to grab. How much? Well, it costs 300 cedis, which is a great deal. The device comes with, well, the router, but they throw in an antenna for you, which allows you to get better reception if you're in a low coverage area. So that antenna alone costs somewhere like $15 to $25. So if you're getting the entire device for 300 cedis, then it means MTN is pulling a lot of strings over there to bring the price down. It's not expensive, neither is it too cheap, so to speak. So it's at a price point that whoever needs such a solution can still afford to buy. So 300 cedis is the price. Walk into any MTN office and it should be good. Does it use a battery? No. It doesn't use a battery. You need to be plugged in all the time. If you are in areas where you don't have electric power but then you still want to use the Wi-Fi or the internet or something like that, so then you might look into MiFi solutions rather than the TableNet. It's electricity only. How many devices or how many connections does it support? The device supports up to 32 devices, so the router can allow 32 devices to connect to it. I remember we connected about 20 to 25 people in Wah during the Jungle Girls event and it worked flawlessly, it was fine. So you shouldn't have any problem with that. If you're in a family and you need more people to connect to a single wireless point, you have 32 devices on the table net, which should be good enough for your use case. So what's the speed like? I get somewhere 5 to 30 megabits per second, depending on where I am. I'm in Cofodia, but then I move around. If I'm in my house, I get somewhere 5 to 15. When I go to my dad's place, I get somewhere 30 sometimes, 30 megabits per second. So your speed is going to vary depending on where you are and whether your antenna is connected and a lot of other factors. So what I'm talking about is a constant within that range is enough for me to stream videos, to download things really fast, and it does everything I need. You know, it's about how constant and reliable it is, and I'm good with it. If you want to know more about how some of the speeds others are getting, you can check my video about the MTN TableNet speed test, where others are sharing speeds of somewhere close to 100 megabits and all that, somewhere in Accra and other places. So you get to have an understanding of what you might be getting out of your TableNet should you get one. How to bundle? There are basically two ways to bundle. I'm using the second approach. The first is you will link an MTN, an existing MTN number, to your TableNet. The TableNet itself can't basically do anything. You can't dial from it. You basically can't bundle with it. The idea is you put it in the device and it's in there. You manage it from elsewhere. So when you link your phone number to the TableNet, it allows you to bundle onto it. It allows you to check how much bundle is left and all that. And I think you would get text messages related to when it's about to expire and all that. That is one way. If you've linked your phone number to your TableNet, then you can use that approach to bundle. The second approach, which is what I use, is you can bundle onto that TableNet device or that SIM number from any MTN number via mobile money. So you would use the *170 hash, select airtime and bundles, and then move on to say fixed broadband. You enter your fixed broadband number for your TableNet, which is going to be the phone number that was given you. That's the SIM, the number of the SIM. You enter it over there, you select the available option you want in terms of the bundle you want, from 20 cities to 395 cities, whichever one you want to buy, and then it allows you to pay using your mobile money. So that is the two ways you can go about it. I use the second approach. I bundle from anywhere because I've not been able to link my account yet, but in any way you should be able to bundle and you should be good to go. Is rollover allowed? Yes, rollover is allowed. You would have to bundle before your 30-day period is over. So just like the normal broadband approach, 30 days, so you have to bundle before it ends and you should be good to go. Whatever bundle you had previously would be carried over to the next one. Do you need to buy the same bundle every month? No, you don't. You can switch between the bundles as and when you want. And so you can buy the biggest bundle and then switch to the smallest bundle the following month. MTN won't be happy if you do that. They want you to buy the biggest bundle because that gives them the biggest money. But you can switch between them as and when you want. There's no restriction there. Speaking of switching between bundles, you can save a ton of money if you go this. Whatever bundle you put on this month, MTN will tell you you need that same amount of money so that they can roll over the next month. You can change between them, and by doing that you end up saving a ton of money. This is what I mean. I went with the biggest bundle, that's the 395 cities, that gives 550 gig. Then the following month I switched to a lower bundle, somewhere 20 cities for 5 gig. The advantage is that you end up saving a lot of money by buying the biggest bundle and switching to lower ones than buying, say, 120 cities for 45 gig every month. Buying the biggest, switching to lowest, saves you a lot of money over a period of time rather than bundling for a lower price point every month. So if you're gonna use it for a longer period of time, I would recommend you buy the biggest one and then just be subscribing with the lowest bundle so that you can get a 30-day extension of your unused data rather than buying somewhere 120 cities or any other bundle for that matter. You save the most when you buy the biggest. So keep that in mind and then just be rolling over every month to save a lot of money over a period of time. So how do you set up your TableNet? It's, if you've used any Huawei routers or MiFis before, you should be familiar with how the interface looks like. This is currently how the interface looks like. So you need to connect on the IP address. So you can see the IP address in the address bar right there. When you go to that address, it opens the admin interface for you. You would need to log in the first time if that's the first time you are connecting to it. So you log in with your admin as password. So username is admin, password is admin, and then you have access to all the functionality the admin UI provides. Now this admin allows you to control the device in its entirety. So you have options to change your Wi-Fi name, to change the password, to configure whether you want to even broadcast your Wi-Fi so that other people can see, how to turn it off. Interestingly, the router comes with support for 4 SSIDs. If you don't know what SSIDs are, basically they are the name that comes up on your phone when you are looking for Wi-Fi. So you can allow this device to broadcast up to 4 different Wi-Fi names that you could put different restrictions on. So you can have one that is for guests, you can have one that is for your kids, and you can have one that you as a parent and maybe your partner uses. So you can have that kind of different Wi-Fi names for different purposes. It allows for extra features that I won't be going into details in this video. Perhaps we'll go over that in a future video, but all the control of this device is in there. And if you've used Huawei, their interface before, it's similar. It's just MTN branded, but then the whole process and the whole flow is similar. Can you use a SIM in a mobile phone? I haven't tried that yet, but I know a friend who has tried that and says it worked. I don't think I would recommend you to do that because MTN doesn't want you to do that. The device, the SIM card is tailored for the TableNet. So it's not designed for making phone calls. It's been designed for data purposes. That's what they call the data SIM. So you could put it in a phone, but don't expect the same mileage from an actual voice and data SIM. It might not work as you expect. And remember that if MTN should learn about that, you stand a chance of having your account blocked. So keep that also in mind. Are there any issues? Well, for me, I have 2 concerns. One is an actual issue. The other one is just probably you can say a pet peeve. When there's a spike in workload, the device goes into no service mode. I don't know how that works. I don't know how to explain it, but let's say I have 2 or 3 devices connected to it. They are all connected, but then just doing minor behind the scenes background. Immediately something goes through the network in a quick fashion. So let's say there was a spike in usage. I opened maybe YouTube, I started downloading a file, something like spiky happens. It cuts the network automatically and says no service. I will have to either change from 3G to 4G, like alternate, so that it will reconnect or restart the device entirely, which is really frustrating when you want to get something done real quick. Some also complain when they are on video or voice calls over the internet, it would go disconnect and say unable to connect or no service mode. It happens. I think it's more like a fail-safe mechanism MTN has put in place so that network spikes like that won't, you know, affect other people on the line or something. I don't know how to explain it, but I feel it's a fail-safe mechanism, more like think of it as an electrical fuse, where if something should go through like really quickly, it just cuts it, and then that's the only way I can explain it. It doesn't make sense, but that's how I can explain it, because on a normal usage it doesn't do that. It only happens when something spikes quickly in the network. The other issue would have to be, which I think it's more of a pet peeve and less of an issue, is the fact that you can't use any other SIM card in the device, and so you would have to unlock the device before you use it, which is something you should be able to do when you go onto the market. These are some of the questions I've been asked since I've been doing MTN TableNet videos, and so I put them all in this video to share with you all. If you know anyone who is considering buying a TableNet and would like to have access to some of these questions, please do well to share with them. I'm gonna leave some of my MTN videos in the link in the description, so you can also learn more about the device. If this is your first time visiting the channel, I do take videos every week, and so you can check around to see some of the videos I've done. And if you like the content, you might want to consider subscribing and clicking the like button and bell icon so that you don't miss any future episodes. My name is Kofi. Thank you for joining me in this one, and hope to see you in the next one.